out 31, I had a question coming out of section 8.1, number 21, and here we were asked to get the equation of the lips in standard form, and then they also wanted the endpoints of the major and minor axis, so let me just write that down so I have that, and they also wanted the coordinates of, let me put axes, and they also wanted the coordinates of the foci, so I need all of that. But to get it into standard form, I'm going to need to complete a square. So I'm going to group the x terms together and the y terms together, and I'm going to move the constant over to the other side of the equation. And that's what you see me doing as of this step. And then it's a matter of we need to complete the square, so we need to figure out what do we want to add here and what do we want to add here to get to a perfect square trinomial. But when you complete a square, the little caveat is that you have to have a Lie coefficient of 1, and right now I have Lie coefficients in front of my squared terms of 4 and 36. So I need to factor those out before I do anything. So that's what you see me doing here. I factored the 4 out of both x terms, and I factored the 36 out of both of the y terms. And then I can go ahead and complete the square. It's always half of the coefficient in front of that linear term, and I square it. Half of the coefficient in front of that linear term, and I square it. And usually we would say, well, if I'm adding 9 and 25 to one side, I need to add it to the other to balance it out. But the thing that you have to remember when you're completing the square is you weren't really adding 9 and 25. You were really adding 9 times 4, which is 36, and 25 times 36, which is 900, which is why you see me adding 36 and 900 to the other side of the equation to balance it out. And then these trinomials are perfect squares, right? X squared minus 6x plus 9 is x minus 3 squared. And y squared minus 10y plus 25 is y minus 5 squared. That's why we specifically added the 9 and the 25 inside those parentheses to turn those into perfect squares. So we're getting closer. All right, but whenever we want to get our equation of our ellipse in standard form, we need this number on the right to be 1. So I'm going to divide everything by 72. And that's what you see me doing at this stage of the game. All right, so let me erase this just so it's not all junked up here. And then I go ahead and I reduce these fractions. 4 over 72 becomes 18. 36 over 72 becomes 2, and 72 over 72 is 1. And that's great. And now I know what my a squared is equal to, right? I can see a squared, it's always the larger number, so it's 18 in this case, and b squared is 2. That makes a the square root of 18, which is 3 root 2, and b is the square root of 2. And I would take the positive roots because we're talking about distance there. So there are my a and b values. I'm also going to go get C, only because it did say here, get the foci. So if we know that C squared is A squared minus B squared, in this case, that would be 18 minus 2. Well, that actually turns out nice. I get, not C squared is 4, but C squared is 16. So C is going to be 4. And I'll keep that in mind as I move forward. I can also read my center. It's 3, 5. So that's great. So we're going to start to put these pieces together, right? So if I was going to graph this thing, I'm going to go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's great. There's my center. All right. And then what I need to do is I need to move 3 root 2 units in the x direction. And I say in the x direction because if we look back here, the 3 root 2 was under the x term. So if you think about root 2, right, that's about 1.7. So it's a little bit less than 2. So if I multiply that by 3, it's going to be a little bit less than 6. So maybe it's about 5.1, somewhere in there if I'm just estimating with my calculator, not with my calculator, with my brain. So I'm going to go about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more units. That would be one endpoint of the major axis. And then I'm going to come back 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. And there would be another endpoint of my major axis. So I have my major axis here, all right? And then I need to go root 2 units. And we said that's about 1.7, and I'm gonna go in the y direction. So I'm gonna go about 2 units up, or about 1.7 units up and 1.7 units down. And there's my minor axis. And from there, I can actually kind of sketch my ellipse. But I need to move off of the center for these. So if I want to think about the endpoints of my major axis, right? So since I'm dealing with the 3√2 number and that's in the x direction, you can see me adding and subtracting 3√2 to my x coordinate. So there are the endpoints of my major axis. And similarly, if we think about √2, that was under the y variable. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to adjust my center 3, 5, but I'm going to plus or minus the √2 to that coordinate. And that's what you see me doing there to get to the endpoints of my minor axis. And then for the foci, we know we need to go C units. Oops, let me not erase all that. I want to go C units, but in the direction of the major axis. So let me color code this. If I want to go C units, and we know C is 4, I'm going to start from my center and I'm going to go 4 units this way and 4 units that way. And again, that's left, right. So that's going to affect my x coordinate. So I'm going to plus or minus 4 here. And that's what you see me doing. And because they're nice whole numbers, I can just say, hey, that's -1, 5, and 7, 5. And that's it. That's all the stuff that they asked me to find. So I found the endpoints of my major and minor axis, and I found my foci. All right. Thanks so much. Bye.